top tier greetings from the wettest region. It is Zeke, live from the Bococo lab, hitting you guys up with my first ever custom review. These are the first two shoes that I had ever produced on a scale where they would be ready for marketing. They are on a pair of LeBron James Soldier 9s that originally came in an all olive military green, hence the dog tags and such, the writing that we'll get into on the straps. And then also the first inspiring custom that I saw on Angelus Direct's Instagram page was these pairs of Hare Jordan Retro 1s that they had done. It was just very, very compelling. I loved the colorways. I loved how it was a different take on the Space Jam concept besides the patent leather 11s. You know, those are very common shoes. You know, they're really trending right now. It's not a bad shoe. It's just trending heavily. So with forethought, I definitely figured that this would be a really cool one-off custom. I've only seen one other pair. I've made two, so that makes three in the world. So this is a very, very, very rare shoe. We will get into these a little bit more in depth, so let's go. So here we have the Air Hares on a Retro 1 silhouette. We've got the Bugs Bunny ears on the side of the left shoe. We've got his carrot on the right shoe. It's exactly how it was depicted on the Angelus Direct page. Again, fat shout out to them. They've given me so much inspiration. If you guys don't know about them yet, none of my work could come about without them. So go ahead and check out their page. They have two, Angelus Direct and Angelus Shoe Polish. They also have many videos on YouTube. Link is down in the description. So go ahead and check them out if you guys want to see some more inspiring art. Now, moving on from where I got the concept from and why I chose it. Because I'm not too big of a Jordan fan, but I love Nikes, clearly. So I felt the Retro 1 concept would be a great kickoff. In addition to that, it's not a normal colorway change. It's got an abstract concept on it, as well as some graphic art. Now, we used all collector edition colors, except for the red. The red is the original red. We used Blaze 8 for the orange. We used a mix of cement for gray and a little bit of black to get the gray for Bugs. We use some hot pink for his inner ear, which is again another standard color. We use some green that we mixed in with some jade to get his carrot foliage. We use the Joker green from the collector edition for the neon green that you see in the color palette. We've got some flat black in there and some beige mixed in with some gold. Now as we come to the front of the shoe, it's a very, very clean silhouette. Very clean indeed. We've got all white leather laces, luxury, status, courtesy of Lace Lab. Go check them out. They got heat for your lacing needs. We decided to go with the white laces with the gold aglets, just so it didn't take away from the crisp white silhouette of the shoe when you're not looking at the side. In addition to that, it goes flush with the tongue with just a little bit of red at the top. All this is factory steel from the toe box, the toe cap, right here on the front rises of the toes. All that is factory. Nothing has been customized except for this upper ankle. The Nike swoosh above it and the side panels, as well as the rear heel side panels. Now we've done this to avoid any cracking for any customers. Customs can get really tricky and they can get really irritating if done incorrectly or rushed or taken care of improperly. So to avoid any of those such complaints or concerns for our customers, we decided to just leave these toe boxes free. Of course, it was shown on the Angelus page that the toe boxes were free as well, but just for future reference, that's one of the reasons we stay away from toe boxes. Very crisp and clean lines. We kept that Jordan sign red and natural. Abstract sizes in the heel alternates of the colors. Those are skewed like they originally were on the Angelus Direct page. Red sole on the inside. These are stocked in size 10 and 11. Both have the luxury leather laces from lacelab.com. Both are complete customs. Both are extremely rare. So these are the Private Propaganda LeBron James Soldier 9s. Again, they came in this olive factory colorway all the way through the shoe. We customized that with four different grays from AngelusDirect.com. We used their gray Cement 4 Playoff 8 gray and the dark gray from the standard colors in order to get this full spectrum fade with a great gradient. All the way down to where the black starts. We also use some of their tuxedo black glitter light for the rear heel tab. Let's see if we can get that to focus in. Here we go. So it's got an onyx look on the back. In addition to that, over the front of the ankle strap are the King James symbol with the crown on it. We hit those up with the black. Faded the inside of the straps, black. They end in that military olive sort of green. Now this pack does come with interchangeable tabs. These are the Akron, Ohio 1984 tabs with the military. I think that, let's see if we can get that to focus in. There we go. There we go. And we left these that military green so that you can alternate at the time of your pleasing. In addition to the interchangeable tabs, we customized the high ankle strap. As well as the writing on it. All the way through. Also got those Lace Lab reflective rope laces in there. Doing their job. You guys can see those work on my Instagram page, where there's a lot of still photos of these. The private propaganda concept comes from a conversation I had with Nate Boyer about how many of the veterans that come home and really commit suicide per day. It got up to 22, I believe, and he would do 22 push-ups every morning, so I started doing the push-ups with him, you know, and we had a deep conversation, as I am a Muslim, about just the ways that police and African Americans are perceived with the goings-ons that are occurring. You guys see the news, I'm sure. So I felt that this was really a cool way to pay it forward, since he really opened up and expressed himself, a way for me to pay it forward for the military. Now, the concept truly does come from the fact of the kind-hearted, good-hearted, patriotic American that sees that he needs to do something for his country. And in times of war, in times of distress and insecurity in a country, all he feels he can do is be a strong young man and go out and serve his country and fight. And he's quickly lost in this gray area where he's fighting for a man and a cause that he truly knows nothing about. And as he gets further and further into it, killing more and seeing more of his friends die, he gets into a darker and darker haze of gray where he needs medicine to cope with the things that he's seen. He needs drugs, or he turns to drugs and alcohol. He cuts his family off. And sooner than later, he fades into the black hole that is suicide, because he no longer has anybody that he feels can understand him or help him. Or the actual Veterans Association doesn't help him. They give him a runaround and send him through loopholes left and right just to get the medicine after he has served this great country. This country that gives all of us an opportunity to make the best of what we have. In comparison to the other lands, we are truly in the best land to make it is what we can. So I felt this was a great way to devote to those who have given their lives so that I can make these videos. Again, these are the private propaganda LeBron James Soldier 9s. All of our concepts here at Bococo will always have a backstory. The concept will always come from something that was compelling. You always get an issue card with your shoe that's got that backstory and concept description upon it. I really hope you guys enjoy the detail of the work that we put out here. I hope you guys enjoy the fact that we put so much effort into the details, that we use a wide array of colors when we do construct our concepts, that we look into the shoe that we're buying as a silhouette and what it can bring to the custom for pertinent uniqueness. We try to go all out and at the same time ensure that you have a custom that is always wearable. We work inside and out on the shoes. As we hit the entirety of this interior up with that cement, used a couple different finishers on here as well, you guys. Thank you. Thanks for tuning in today, you guys, for my first ever custom review. I hope you guys enjoyed the content and the backstory on my first ever customs. Just look back in a year from now and see how far we'll have come. I think it'll be pretty cool to see all the work that I put out this year. And for you guys that are just now subscribing, just now starting to follow me, I truly appreciate every time you guys tune in. I truly do this for you guys, so you guys can get a better inside look at the custom game. I felt it was pertinent for me to do a custom review right now instead of the garbage to green, for the simple fact that I have unique sneak tweaks going on later on in the week. And then we have a business shout out on Friday. So I felt having two custom slash restoration videos in 1 week was kind of pushing it. When I see a lot of other people that do a thrift video or, you know, different on-feet reviews or release reviews and so forth. So I feel a good balance will be met by having a review on Monday, customization slash restoration on Wednesdays, and then go out into the small business world on Fridays. Hope you guys are enjoying all the content. As always, have a great and blessed day. This is Zeke, live in the Bococo Lab, signing out. Shout out to that Rob Lowe.